The aircraft carrier is a symbol of might and power, a floating fortress that rules the seas. Its sheer size alone makes it an intimidating force to be reckoned with. But what many people don't know is that U.S. aircraft carriers are virtually impossible to sink, making them even more formidable. With all the technology and design considerations that have gone into creating the modern-day aircraft carrier, it is no surprise that these vessels can withstand almost anything thrown at them. But why are they so difficult to take down? What kind of advanced defensive systems do U.S. aircraft carriers have that make them so resilient? Are there any potential weaknesses or vulnerabilities that could threaten the unsinkability of these vessels in the future? Stay tuned to find out. Here are 10 reasons why U.S. aircraft carriers are virtually impossible to sink. Number 10. Blessing in movement. Mobile carriers are always on the go. Also, their speed is impressive, making it possible for them to evade capture by most submarines. Current Nimitz-class carriers in the Navy can go to any location within a 700-square-mile range in less than 30 minutes, thanks to their 35-mile-per-hour top speeds. In only 90 minutes, it will have expanded to cover more than 6,000 square miles. So, for the enemy, just locating a carrier is not the same as effectively attacking it. It will probably be gone by the time their guns get there. Number 9. Nuclear propulsion to the rescue. U.S. carriers have an unlimited range. Despite their massive size, the Nimitz-class and its successor, the Ford-class, have virtually limitless range because of nuclear propulsion. Even if the gasoline tankers supplying the rest of the fleet are intercepted, it won't have any effect on their operations. Carriers powered by nuclear reactors can perform long, evasive maneuvers beyond the reach of most enemy forces. Number 8. Incredible defense system. Carrier air wings can destroy enemy combat systems before they get near. Dozens of F/A-18 and F-35 fighters, both with high-tech sensors and laser-guided weaponry, make up a typical carrier air wing. It will also include electronic warfare planes called Growlers that can disrupt enemy radar and communications from great distances. These aircraft are so superior that they can stop an assault on a carrier far before the enemy reaches a range where they can do any damage. Number 7. Layer after layer. Carrier sensors are netted with other friendly assets. The Navy has spent decades perfecting a system to link together its disparate warfighting weapons. Hence, carriers in deployment won't have to depend only on their own internal sensors to identify threats. They will also get constant data from other sources, including surface and subsurface warships, manned and unmanned aircraft, and even circling reconnaissance satellites. The carrier will have complete situational awareness, and it will be able to employ distant warships' weaponry to intercept threats that its own defenses can't handle. Number 6. Teamwork makes the dream work. Carriers never deploy alone. No matter if they are going to the Western Pacific, the Persian Gulf, or the North Sea, U.S. carriers never leave port without escorts. These include many surface combatants with cutting-edge air and missile defenses, as well as nuclear-powered attack submarines with an unrivaled capacity to locate and kill enemy ships, above or below the water. Upgrades to the surface warships include a new generation of armaments to counteract aerial threats and a radar 100 times more capable than the previous generation. Submarines are constantly upgraded to keep up with underwater enemies like the Soviet military. Number 5. Multifaceted defensive system. Carrier defenses are layered to provide in-depth protection. Carrier strike groups set up multi-tiered defenses that may span hundreds of kilometers, making it difficult for potential enemies to approach within firing range. It includes missiles, planes, submarines, and anything else that may pose a danger. The benefit of a layered defense is that the carrier can be protected even if a single layer fails. If, for example, each of the three levels has an 80% success rate, then the number of successful infiltrators will probably be fewer than 1 in 100. Number 4. Self-sufficient. Carriers have extensive onboard defenses. In addition to the passive defenses discussed previously, each carrier is outfitted with active defenses, such as multiple air defense radars, surface-to-air missiles, automated guns to deal with sea-skimming threats, electronic warfare systems to deceive the sensors and disrupt the command links of incoming threats, and an anti-torpedo system. U.S. aircraft carriers may be lacking in anti-torpedo defenses due to a Navy decision, but they nonetheless have a wide variety of other organic defensive systems. Number 3. Not knowing is part of the fun. Secrecy complicates attack plans. According to those with knowledge of the Navy, many of the defensive measures used on U.S. carriers are never made public. This implies that any strategy for attacking a carrier will need guesswork about how to overcome potential defenses. There are so many obstacles that an aggressor would have to overcome before even attempting to get to the carrier. Number 2. Mighty beasts. Ships of this size are nearly impossible to sink. Because they are so big, U.S. aircraft carriers have a lot of watertight compartments. They are also protected by armor that weighs thousands of tons and has redundancy systems for important systems like electrical wiring. This means that even if a single weapon were to get through the defenses, it would not likely do significant damage to the carrier. The ship won't go down, and the crew can probably repair the damage they sustained so they can go on with their mission. The carrier's bulk, which has been cited as a potential weakness, actually makes it stronger than any other kind of warship. Number 1. Best is yet to come. The Ford class of carriers will have improved defensive features. The Navy has started receiving a new generation of aircraft carriers that provide even superior defense than the Nimitz class, which makes up the majority of the present fleet. For example, the Ford class will provide more than 600 megawatts of power to power sensors, networks, and weapon systems on board. High-powered lasers, electromagnetic railguns, and other unusual weapons with no known countermeasures may one day be installed with the help of the extra power. To believe that a U.S. aircraft carrier is absolutely impossible to sink would be naive. While large, sturdy, and well-protected, there's a good chance that one may be sunk by a determined enemy armed with the correct armaments. The United States has been fortunate in that, since World War II, it has avoided any conflicts with opponents who might mount such a threat. It should be noted, however, that sinking an aircraft carrier is no simple feat. As we discussed, these vessels have extensive defense systems and are built to endure massive amounts of punishment. And icing on the cake is that the United States Navy maintains a fleet of support ships, including destroyers and cruisers, that are armed and prepared to protect an aircraft carrier if necessary. Thanks for watching this video. If you're new to this channel, I strongly encourage you to subscribe and click the like button. Until next time, this is Fleet Files signing off. See you in the next video.